Hey friends, welcome to the YouTube channel All About Electronics. So in this video, we will understand the concept of transconductance in the MOSFET. And then after, we will see the small signal model of the MOSFET. So this small signal model of the MOSFET is particularly useful when the MOSFET is used as an amplifier. And using this small signal model, it is easy to analyze the MOSFET circuits. But first of all, let us understand the concept of transconductance. So far in our discussion, we have understood that to use the MOSFET as an amplifier, it should be operated in the saturation region, because in this region, the MOSFET acts like a voltage controlled current source, and the drain current is a function of voltage VGS. But if you see the relationship between the drain current and the voltage VGS, then it is nonlinear. So keeping this characteristic in mind, let's say some AC input signal which needs to be amplified is applied on top of the biasing voltage. Now whenever there is a small change around the voltage VGS, then there will be also change around the drain current ID. But the amount of change in this drain current ID depends on the biasing point. For example, if this biasing point shifts on the right hand side, then for the same change in the voltage VGS, now we will see a more change in the drain current. That means for the given change in the voltage VGS, the amount of change in the drain current is the bias dependent, and it is defined as the transconductance of the MOSFET. So mathematically, this transconductance is equal to the change in the drain current divided by the change in the voltage VGS. That means for the given change in the voltage VGS, how much change will occur in the drain current. And graphically, it is the slope of the curve at the operating point. Now, as you are aware, this drain current ID can be given as half times mu n times COx times W by L times VGS minus VT whole square. And here we are assuming that the lambda is equal to 0. So to get the expression of the transconductance, let us differentiate this expression with respect to VGS. That means GM is equal to DID divided by DVGS. That is equal to half times 2 times mu n times COx times W by L times VGS minus VT. That is equal to mu n times COx times W by L times VGS minus VT. So this transconductance relates the output current with the input voltage. And the unit of this transconductance is the Siemens. So from this expression, as you can see, for the given MOSFET parameters or for the given MOSFET, the transconductance is proportional to VGS minus VT. Or if VGS minus VT is kept fixed, then this GM is proportional to W by L. Now there is another expression of the transconductance. So as we have seen, this drain current ID can be given by this expression. And from this expression, we can say that voltage VGS minus VT is equal to square root of 2 times ID divided by mu n times COx times W divided by L. So let us put the value of VGS minus VT in this expression. And if you put the value, then this transconductance GM can be given as square root of 2 times ID times mu n times COx times W divided by L. So this expression of the transconductance says that for the given MOSFET parameters, this transconductance is proportional to square root of ID. Or for the fixed value of the drain current ID, this GM is proportional to square root of W divided by L. Apart from these two expressions, there is one more expression for the transconductance. So if we divide these two expressions, then GM divided by ID will be equal to 2 divided by VGS minus VT. Or we can say that this transconductance GM is equal to 2 times ID divided by VGS minus VT. So from this expression, we can say that when the drain current ID is kept fixed, then the transconductance is inversely proportional to this VGS minus VT. Or for the given value of the voltage VGS minus VT or the overdrive voltage, this GM is directly proportional to the drain current. So in the MOSFET, there are three parameters. One is the drain current, second is this W by L ratio, and the third one is VGS minus VT. So depending on which parameter is kept constant, the relation of these three parameters with the transconductance will change. Alright, so now once we understood the concept of transconductance, let us see the small signal model of the MOSFET. And for that, let us take the simple MOSFET circuit. So this circuit is biased with some DC voltage such that it is operating in the saturation region. And on top of this DC biasing voltage, some AC input signal Vin is applied. Now as we have seen so far, in the saturation, the drain current ID can be given by this expression. And in this case, if you see, this voltage VGS is equal to VDC plus VI. So if you put the value of VGS in this expression, then the drain current ID can be given as half times mu n times Cox times W divided by L times VI plus VDC minus VT whole square. So as you can see, the relationship between the AC input signal Vin and the drain current ID is still nonlinear. But if this input signal Vin is very small, or under the small signal approximation, the change in the drain current is linearly proportional to the input signal Vin. And in that case, the MOSFET can be replaced by the small signal model. So let us understand that concept mathematically. So in this expression, if this VI is much smaller than this VDC minus VT, then the second order term in this expansion can be neglected. So if we just expand this bracket, then we can write this drain current ID as half times mu n times Cox times W divided by L times VI square plus VDC minus VT whole square plus 2 times VI times VDC minus VT. So in this case, when this input signal is much smaller than this VDC minus VT, then this Vin square can be neglected. So if we further rearrange this expression, then we can write it as half times mu n times Cox times W divided by L times VDC minus VT whole square plus mu n times Cox times W divided by L times VDC minus VT times Vin. So this first term represents the DC current or the biasing drain current. Let's call it as ID0. And if you observe the second term carefully, then this expression is the expression of the transconductance, right? So from this we can say that the overall drain current is equal to ID0 plus GM times input signal. So this ID0 is the DC drain current, and this GM times Vin is the change in the drain current due to the input signal. That means under the small signal approximation, the total response of this MOSFET is the summation of the DC response and the AC response. And using the principle of the superposition, the DC and the AC analysis can be done separately. So while considering the DC analysis, the AC signal can be assumed as 0, and similarly, during the AC analysis, this DC voltage can be assumed as 0. So as you can see, under this small signal approximation, the change in the drain current is linearly proportional to the input signal Vin. And in that case, the MOSFET can be replaced by the small signal equivalent model. So here, this VGS is the input signal which is applied between the gate and the source terminal. And the change in the drain current is linearly proportional to this VGS. Now in this model, if you also consider the effect of the channel length modulation, then there will also be an output resistance. But for simplicity, for a moment let us assume that the lambda is equal to 0. So under the small signal approximation, the MOSFET can be replaced by this small signal model. So once again, let us consider this circuit. And for the given circuit, let us do the AC analysis. So here, if this input signal Vin is very small, then the MOSFET can be replaced by the small signal model. So for the AC analysis, all the DC sources in the circuit can be assumed as zero. That means this VDC will act as a zero. And similarly, this VDD will also get connected to the ground. And now, the MOSFET can be replaced by the small signal model. So in this small signal model, this input signal Vin is appearing between the gate and the source terminal. While if you see this drain resistor RD, then it is appearing between the drain terminal and the ground terminal. And here, since the source terminal is also grounded, so we can say that this resistor RD will appear between the drain and the source terminal. And if the output is measured between this drain and the source terminal, then the Vout can be given as minus GM times VGS times RD. Or in this case, it will be equal to minus GM times Vin times RD, because this current is flowing in the clockwise direction. So from this, we can say that the voltage gain or the AC voltage gain Vout divided by Vin is equal to minus GM times RD. So in this way, using the small signal approximation and using this small signal model, the AC analysis becomes very simple. And whenever the MOSFET is used as an amplifier, then it becomes very easy to find the approximate gain of the amplifier. So in the upcoming videos, we will see that how the MOSFET can be used as an amplifier in the different configurations. And using the AC analysis, we will also derive the expression of the gain for each configuration. But I hope in this video, you understood the concept of the transconductance for the MOSFET. And you also learned how the MOSFET can be replaced by the small signal model for the AC analysis. So if you have any question or suggestion, then do let me know here in the comment section below. If you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe the channel for more such videos.